Hi, good afternoon. I'm speaking on behalf of a number of people who are here. I'm the Regional Director for East and Southeast Asia and Oceania for AVRDC, the World Vegetable Centre. And the mission of AVRDC is to alleviate poverty and to... it does work. I was getting a bit worried there. Is to alleviate poverty and malnutrition through increased production and consumption of safe, affordable, year-round, health-promoting vegetables. We're an international research organisation that produces technologies that drive development, global non-profit. As we collectively move towards nutritional security rather than food security, vegetables are the key, because we have lots of nutrient-dense proteins, microelements, vitamins, minerals, and these are unique. And what's also unique about vegetables is that they can be produced in a small amount of land in a small amount of time by comparison with staples. So this offers the opportunity for women to be empowered to actually manage a garden close to their homestead. It also offers the opportunity for women to actually access these nutrients to feed their household members and also to supply consumers via market access. And a key thing, vegetables make money, which gives lots of opportunities for input suppliers. Now, thinking of Cambodia, one of the key constraints is a lack of good quality seed. Now, this low quality seed jeopardizes yield, profit, and sustainable value webs. So what AVRDC is doing is, through breeding programs, selecting improved material, which is actually better adapted to the environmental conditions of Cambodia and the market preferences. And these are heat tolerant, disease and resistant tolerant, and also training people in how to multiply the seed so the seed is available. Now, what AVRDC boasts is the largest collection of vegetables in the world, both traditional vegetables and global, and these have been characterized in terms of the traits that they have. And at the heart of everything that AVRDC does is use this biodiversity and select through breeding programs those optimal varieties and using the right production methods to make sure the nutrients are safeguarded and then consumers can access them through awareness and through the right recipes. We need to make sure that what is being provided is safe, and the current practice of using cocktails of pesticides needs to change. And it can. If we give people the power to diagnose what's the problem, we can then identify what is the appropriate control intervention. It can be an agronomic practice, it can be the likes of grafting, it can be the use of pheromone traps, biological control. If chemicals are used, they need to be used appropriately. I didn't expect that. Just by way of example, Ralstonia, soil-borne bacterium, this can be controlled through clean seed, clean water, clean soil. Should there be the disease present, remove diseased plants, use grafted seedlings, and use resistant material. Home gardens. The key three pillars are vegetable seed packs, training to be able to manage this germplasm, and rigorous scientific evaluation to then refine the profile of seed packs and also the training mechanisms. In over 20 countries, AVRDC has successfully provided guidance to allow home gardens to provide nutrition to homesteads, and also encouraged people managing these gardens to go for a more commercial approach by aggregating together their expertise. To do this, to link with the field and the market, we need to reduce post-harvest losses. What's the problem? What's the solution? How do we empower people to then implement these technologies? A key thing is that the technologies need to be implemented at the pack house. This is where the scale is feasible. And this links lots of disaggregated farmers to the markets through the pack house. Consumers also need to be made aware of what and how they prepare their vegetables to gain the nutrients. This is a list of some of the technologies for post-harvest. We have many projects developing lots of technologies, and all of these are shared collectively through training programs that we coordinate on an annual basis. One example is the International Vegetable Training Course, which involves nearly everybody here as a resource person. And it's the 35th year this year. We've already trained 1,000 people from 46 countries. AVRDC also networks, and we're very strongly linked with ASEAN, and I'll be in Malaysia next week, and the target of that ASEAN meeting is vegetables linkages with nutrition and health. We also organise a scientific symposia, again in Malaysia later in the year, CVEG 2016, looking at improved nutrition, improved livelihoods. Now, I'm one of many. Stu is here who can help with the home gardens. June can help with the post-harvest. We'll be here afterwards. And we also have a booth later and we can provide lots of further information.